So it is Thursday, like less than 2 weeks till I fly out. The lighting in here is terrible. And I'm going to go do some posing practice with Chauncey Wilson. He is a client of Matt's as well, that is local to Louisville. And we're gonna be doing some posing at Factory. So hopefully I will see you guys in the next clips of posing. Bye-bye.
At certain sets,
they're stronger and they're pushing their squats a lot, and then they're trying to work their technique a lot. Well, it's kind of challenging to work all the technical movements when your legs are fatigued and you're really trying to push your squats and you're stronger. So what it does is it identifies that balance. So we're like, hey, if you're going to really...
So do you want your body, or do you want to face in the mirror?
My body's fine. My body's fine. Oh, this is so uncomfortable.
Because it's catching us in an angle.
Okay, that's fine. Okay. Mm-hmm. I mean, all the angles. Because this thing's supposed to fit like above that hip bone, right?
Yeah, and it's going to sit down. That's why I keep telling you to sit back on your hips, because it brings out the more definition. See how much this tightened up?
Mm-hmm.
Quarter turns are right.
That's good. Oh, jeez. Damn.
It sucks. Trust me. That's when you know you're doing it right, because when your low back
comes up. This is the first time I've been in this much pain.
Oh, yeah? Mm-hmm. Even if you're 10 pounds heavier than you are now, still put you in a position where you need to be in. You're going to see everything going. The minute you get, the more you're going to be able to twerk certain things. Like, okay, my arm looks better when I bring it.
Oh, God, look at my back.
That's what I was asking, if you were seeing your bag.
Oh my God.
That was awesome. Yeah.
What is that?
This?
Yeah.
It's mid-back thickness. It's been working 100
Jeez. I do most of my own. I mean,
that's why when you're doing certain poses, I'm like, do you see your back? Like, move over here. Like, back's awesome.
I mean, I've been doing manual my own training. I mean, he doesn't write my training.
Oh, yeah? Well, mm-hmm. The program you're doing is working for you. I mean, I didn't see it before now.
It's called the same shit, just more weight.
Yeah, exactly, right?
It's the same shit, more weight.
But some people just try to confuse it on putting in so much different stuff.
No, I pretty much do the same things.
Basic.
Same things. I get all my variations and grips and do it and then leave.
There you go. It's getting the work done. Without trying to be like, oh, this program's not working, and you tried it for 2 weeks.
Yeah. I turn my hands out to keep them smaller.
And it emphasizes the ones I'm showing you. You just curve it out your body with your arms.
I'm gonna relax in a second, I'm
gonna
get
cramped. You're good, you're relaxed. I know how hard it is, and it sucks.
Oh, now.
That's when people are like, my lower back hurts. I'm like, you're doing it right then.
Yeah. This is much better.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's a good thing. Head on my back, dude. Yeah, can you imagine, like, look at your back just standing there. That's when I'm like, do you see your back? It's crazy.
What is that?
Your lower back's doing. I don't know how well you can do the beginning. You may not flex.
No, I'm not. And it's Friday. I have overnight. Bikini's Friday night. So evening I'll be fuller anyways.
Yeah.
And then Saturday, midday is figure. We don't have prejudging.
I want to see those pictures. Bikini and figure. Like, what did she do overnight?
I don't know, I'm excited to see what he does to me overnight. Like, if he's just like...
It's night and day. Like, when I first did with men, I took him on like 5 days out from my show.
I remember that, because that's when I saw you, was that Muscle? When you took the overall?
The Derby.
Or Derby, when you took the overall?
Yeah. I was nervous on hitting him up. I was like, I don't know what he can do in 5 days. Well, he did.
Mm-hmm.
I've been with him ever since. Even when you get in that pose and you gotta be like, stand tall, like it's gonna emphasize a lot smaller waistline. As soon as you drop, like, relax. See the difference in your waistline? Mm-hmm. Then when you pull back up, everything tightens up in definition of your abs and stuff coming out a lot more. See, one elongate is just gonna make everything tighter. I mean, see the difference?
Mm-hmm.
That's why I understand when people get on stage and don't flex. I'm like, it's no way you're going to be able to show anything if you don't flex. I don't care if you're a bikini girl, you still got to flex. That's good shit. I'm gonna see what you look like that down. You gotta go back out to California to do a show?
Miami. Leave in 2 weeks.
Slightly bend that elbow in that pose. When you slightly bend it, bend it a little bit more. See the definition of your shoulder that rounds out a lot more than this one.
Okay.
Back from my posing session that you saw in some of those clips, and thank you so much, Chauncey, for your help with that and for teaching me the chest high, arch back, and giving me a waist in my quarter turns so I don't look like a square box in my waist. But anywho, so I had to wake up pretty early to get my cardio in before I did the posing. So I missed my quiet time for the morning, my coffee. So I'm doing that now and reading the book you saw in the previous video, which I will link below, this Mastering Your Mean Girl, and No Hershey. Sorry, they're laying our sod, so Hershey's like barking at everybody outside, and you probably hear all the lawnmowers, but anywho, so I just wanted to chat with you guys a little bit about what I just read, because it was really moving for me, and it was kind of like perfect for me and what I'm wrapping up here. I really like can't believe I've been able to do what I've done in the short amount of time I've done it. I'm not saying that I'm going to be the best figure competitor up there, but I'm damn sure gonna be one of the proudest figure competitors up there, because after posing today, I have a renewed sense of confidence in myself in this process, and I'm like getting ready and getting excited to present like the hard work I've put in on stage. And posing is really how you do that. You can have the best physique on stage, but especially with figure, if you're not posing correctly, it's gonna all get hidden, because I've been, you know, having people, wonderful people come up to me and talk about my back, but in my progress pictures, like, it was not there. So I was like, what is everybody seeing? Because I don't see it in my progress pictures. They were terrible. I was like sending them off to coach, like hitting the send button going, oh, what's he gonna say? It looks so bad. But anywho, so working with Chauncey today, I got to see really what people were seeing and saying about my back, and I'm getting it, and it's coming together, and I'm allowed to be confident in myself, and I'm allowed to be proud of what I have done. So this chapter in Mastering Your Mean Girl was, it was focusing on spirituality, and that's one thing that this prep, I've since the move, and since my life has kind of calmed down, I have really like made that a priority in my life, and really focus on myself and believing in myself and what I'm able to accomplish. So I just kind of wanted to read this excerpt for you watching, and you're welcome to read this book and share your comments below, or share if you've read this, or hit me up on Instagram or Snapchat. But this was a really great insert or excerpt. Yeah, this was a really great excerpt. Spirituality is the state of being. It's an intuitive, deep down knowingness that we are connected to all things everywhere. Spirituality says that even though you may think you are limited and small, you are not. You're greater and more powerful than you have ever imagined. You are magnificent, and an almighty light exists within you just as it lives within everyone and everything. There is no separation, just oneness. And man, I came home after an awesome posing session and read that you're greater and more powerful than you ever imagined. Wow. I feel great. I feel powerful. And I feel so proud of myself. And whatever it is in your life that you're seeking to accomplish or do, impress yourself. Make yourself proud. Make yourself feel powerful. It's all within you. So, another emotional vlog. Sorry about that, but that was awesome. And it's exactly what I needed to hear. And sometimes you need to hear that yourself. So there's that. And I plan on doing something a little bit more relaxing and meditative with you guys later in the following clips. I'm going to get my massage today because 2.5 weeks out, or about 2 weeks out, is the best time for me to get a massage, not the week out. So, I'm gonna take advantage of that. I found a new person in town. Hopefully they're good. I don't know. It always makes me a little nervous to go to new massage therapists, especially this close. But anywho, so I'll share with you guys all that. And yeah, that'll be my day. So, you are powerful. Just remember that. All right, so I just got back from training and I wanted to do something creative. So the Lululemon store where I work, a bunch of succulent terrariums all over the store, and they're just really peaceful. And I wanted to make my own since I can't keep living plants in the house because I kill them. I just buy flowers at the store. But so here are my supplies. I've got some sheet moss, some marble nuggets, and I picked out two succulents and then one little cactus. And this is my terrarium that I got from World Market, and it's like rose gold. It is so cute. I love it. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this stuff together. I'm no Martha Stewart for show. After looking about succulent terrariums online, I think I was supposed to use sand maybe to catch water or absorb water. I don't really know if, I don't know. If you know, comment below if I did this wrong, if you've ever done one. This is where I wanted it to go in my little office nook. And my cactus won't really stay upright. I guess that's why you need sand. But I still think it turned out really cute. No, she's so cute. But I mean, it's cute, right? It's peaceful, right? I don't know. If you liked this crazy video of posing and succulent terrariums, then be sure to subscribe below, give me a thumbs up, comment below. If you think it's crazy that I included posing in a succulent terrarium in one video and you think it's terrible, that's fine too. But anywho, have a wonderful rest of your day and thank you for following my run for two, which is almost over. Have a wonderful day. Mwah.